here's sort of what the box looks like. It's got an open top, so this top isn't here, but the base is square, which means each side is X, or we could represent it with the letter X, and Y could be the height of the box. And so the volume of the box would be X times Y, length times width times height. And the reason that they give us this information that the volume is 252 meters cubed is so that we can find Y in terms of X. But then it's the cost function that we have to create and then hopefully minimize. So the cost function says that the cost of the base is $40 per square meter. Well, if each side is X meters, then there's X square meters in the base, X squared square meters in the base multiplied by 40. This is going to represent the cost of the base. As far as the sides go, there's four sides, each with an area of X times Y. And X times Y times 4 would give me the total number of square meters, and each of those square meters is $30 right here. And of course, I use this value for Y in the cost function so that I have the cost in terms of the variable X. And I've written this, the second term is 4 times 30 times 252 times X to the minus 1, because one of these X's cancels out. And by the way, notice over here that I've created the cost function on the Desmos Online graphing calculator, indicating that X must be greater than zero. First of all, we can't divide by zero. And secondly, it wouldn't make any sense to have a square base that was at a side length that was negative or even zero. So now we're going to take the derivative of the cost function, set it equal to zero, and see if we get maximum or minimum. Well, if I take the derivative of the first term, I get 80x. Here I have to use the power rule, minus 1 times, reduce the exponent by 1. I can write that as all over x squared. If I go to board 2 and set the derivative equal to 0, which I've done here, I can solve this for X by multiplying every term by X squared. And I'll get 80X cubed minus this numerator. And then I can add this numerator to both sides, or transpose that term to the other side of the equal sign. Divide by 80, cancel out. And I see that I get 3 times 126. This is really 126 written in prime factored form. So I can see that X is the cube root of 3 factors of 3. 3 cubed times 2 times 7, or 14. I can take the cube root of 3 cubed and get 3. So 3 cube root of 14 represents the dimension of the base. And you could get an exact value for Y by substituting that right here. On Desmos, I just said X of 1 is 3 times the cube root of 14, about 7.23 meters. Y sub 1 would end up being about 4.78 meters. And if I put the cost, X sub 1 into the cost function, I see it's going to cost me about $6,273.49 to build this pretty expensive box. Okay, and if I go to Desmos, just so you can see what happens if I create a table, you can see that if I let the side of the box be 1, that the cost would be pretty exorbitant. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Between 7 and 8 seems to be the value that we're looking for. And it turns out it is 7.23, as shown over here. Okay, hope that to be totally precise, we'd have to also prove that that value of X generates a minimum value by using one of the tests that proves that a critical number generates either a maximum or a minimum. Okay, but we'll skip that step for now.